Okay, so now we are going to look at a question. They have given you a system which is performing this multiplication operation. Basically, this represents a multiplier. So this input is getting multiplied with cos omega ct and the output is thus obtained. So they are asking you about to check whether the system is memoryless, causal, linear, time invariant, stable. So they are asking you to check all the classification that we have studied about the system. So what we are doing is, firstly I am representing this equation mathematically, modeling the system. Now what is going to be the mathematical model of the system? Output yt is going to be equal to cos omega ct into xt, fine, because this is just performing the multiplication operation of the input signal with cos omega ct. So this is going to be yt. Now we're going to look at all the properties one by one. Now how do we identify if a system is static or dynamic? This system does not depend on any past values of input, therefore it is not having any provision of memory. So the system is going to be memoryless or static. Static means this depends on only the present values of input, right? Now look at the next part. Causal or non-causal system, how are we determining causality of a system? If a system does not depend on future values of input, if it depends only on present or past values of the input, we say that the system is causal. Since this output of the system depends only on the present values of the input, the system is going to be a causal system, right? Now next day we are going to check linearity. So to check linearity, I am considering an input xt which is equal to alpha 1 x1t plus alpha 2 x2t. Okay, I am checking homogeneity as well as superposition using a single signal. If I apply this xt to this system, output yt is going to be which is equal to right. Now this is equal to alpha 1 y1t plus alpha 2 y2t, right? If you had applied x1t separately to this system, you would have yielded this, right? So this is satisfying superposition as well as homogeneity, which means that this system is going to be linear. This is a linear system since it satisfies both homogeneity as well as superposition. Okay. Now they are asking you to check time invariance. How are we checking time invariance? Firstly, you are going to produce a delay of t naught in the input. If I delay the input by t naught, the output that I am going to yield is, see, now you can see from here, if this input gets delayed by t naught, this is going to be t minus t naught, but still it is going to be multiplied with cos omega ct only. Okay, so the output is going to be cos omega ct into x of t minus t naught. Whereas if you are producing a delay of t naught in the output, what happens? Every independent variable in this RHS is going to be replaced by t minus t naught, which makes it cos omega c into t minus t naught into x of t minus t naught. Since both of them are not equal, the system is going to be time variant system, right? Now in the last part, they are asking you to check stability of the system. Now see, in this system, this cos omega ct, we know about cos function, right? This cos omega ct, mod of this cos omega ct is always going to be less than equal to 1. Value of cos ranges from minus 1 to 1. So this is going to have values between minus 1 and 1 only. If this xt is bounded, that is if xt is having finite value, then on multiplication with cos, yt is going to be bounded always, right? Because this is going to have values between minus 1 and 1 only. So if xt is bounded, okay, xt is bounded, then yt mod yt is going to be bounded, which means that this system is Bebo stable. So this is a stable system, right? So this is how we're checking properties of a system. Next we're going to look at an example of discrete time system. So now we're given a discrete time system. This element, this is a unit delay element. What it does is, this is just going to delay this input by one unit time, okay? So what is this output going to be? this is going to get delayed. That is, if we are talking about the time instance n, we are going to get input of instance n minus 1. This is what this unit delay element does, okay? It is going to produce a delay of unity, delay of 1. Fine. So, this is going to be the mathematical equation relating this system. Now, we are going to check if the system is having memory. See, since the output depends on previous input which occurred 1 unit time before. So, the system is going to be with memory. The system is going to have a provision of memory. So, this is a dynamic system. Dynamic system or not memoryless. Not memoryless, right? Fine. Now, we are checking causality of the system. Now, see, the output at present time instance does not depend on future values of the input. It depends on past value of the input. So, this system is going to be a causal system. To check causality, we just need to check if the output depends on future values of the input. Since here, the output depends only on the past value of the input, this is going to be a causal system, right? Now, to check linearity, I am considering a input xn, which is alpha 1 x1n plus alpha 2 x2n. Now, when I apply this input to the system, what is the output that I am going to get? Alpha 1 x1n minus 1 plus alpha 2 x2n minus 2, which is equal to alpha 1 y1 plus alpha 2 y2, where y1 and y2 are the individual outputs when these signals would have been applied to this system. Okay, so this is satisfying superposition as well as homogeneity. So this is going to be a linear system, linear discrete time system, right? Now, to check time invariance, what do I do? Firstly, I am producing a delay of n0 in the input, which is going to yield an output of x of n minus n0 minus 1. When you produce a delay of same amount n0 in the output, you are going to get it n minus n0 minus 1, which is same. So, this is going to be a time invariant system, time invariant. Now, to check stability, see, if xn is bounded, if xn lies between some particular time intervals, if this xn is bounded, then xn minus 1 is also going to be bounded. Why? See, because if a signal is bounded, even if you delay it, even if you shift it by 1 unit, it is going to remain bounded, okay? So, therefore, if xn minus 1 is bounded, yn is equal to this one only, okay? Therefore, yn is also going to be bounded. So, system is going to be Bebo stable, bounded input, bounded output stable. So, this is how we are checking these parameters for a discrete time. So, in this question, we are given a system T and we are given 3 different inputs that have been applied to T and their corresponding outputs. So, we are given that the system is time invariant. Already, we know that the system is time invariant. Now, they are asking you to check linearity of the system. Okay. So, see, if you carefully look at this third input, X3n, you can see that this input consists of X1n. It consists of a sample at n is equal to 2 of value 2. And a sample of value 1 which is shifted by 2 units. So, I can say that x3n is actually equal to x1n plus x2 which has been shifted by 2 units to right, which means x2 of n minus 2. If I just sketch x2n minus 2, which means shifting this right by 2 units, and add these two signals, I am going to obtain x3n. Now see, if the system is linear, then what should happen? Linearity means it should follow superposition as well as homogeneity. Homogeneity is not present here, so it must follow superposition. Also, we know that the system is time invariant. If the system is time invariant, then output for x2n minus 2 must be equal to y2n minus 2. So, I can say that if the given system is linear, then what should happen? Y3n should be equal to y1n plus y2 n minus 2. This should be satisfied, right? This is what linearity is, okay? Now we're going to check if this condition is true or not. Already you know that y1 n is consisting of two samples at n is equal to 2 and n is equal to 3. I'm sketching y2 n minus 2. If I just sketch, if I want to obtain y2 n minus 2, what do I have to do? I have to shift the sample to right by 2 units. So what does happen? We obtain a sample of value 2 at n is equal to 1. This is what y2 n minus 2 looks like. Now if you just add these two signals, okay, if you just add y1 n and this y2 n minus 2, what are you going to obtain? Let's see. Right, so I'm going to obtain a sample of value 2 at n is equal to 1, a sample of value 1 at n is equal to 2, and a sample of value 2 again at n is equal to 3. Right, I'm adding these two signals, I'm going to obtain this. Now just check if this yn is equal to y3n. Clearly, these two signals are not equal, which means that this system is not satisfying the condition of linearity. It is not satisfying superposition. So this system is going to be non-linear in nature. Okay, since it does not satisfy superposition. Okay.